Hello, my name is Jeroen Schotsaert, and I'm pleased to share with you some information about the realization of the coating plant for the segments of the primary mirror of the extremely large telescope, currently under construction by the European Southern Observatory in Chile. The extremely large telescope, the ELT, will be the largest optical near and mid-infrared telescope in the world, with a dome height of 80 meters. The telescope is scheduled for first light in the second half of the 2020s. The coating plant for the primary mirror segments is designed and manufactured by AGC Plasma Technology Solutions, a business unit within AGC Glass Europe. The telescope consists out of five reflecting surfaces that focus the light into a science instrument. The primary mirror, M1, is a 39-meter wide concave mirror, and due to this huge surface, the mirror is a segmented mirror consisting out of 798 segments in total. The individual mirror segments are quasi-hexagonal, about 1.5 meter in size with a sag of about 3 mm to make the mean radius of curvature of the primary mirror of 68.7 meter. Each segment is mounted on a support structure, containing also motors, edge sensors and electrical cables. The structure and sensors will not be disassembled during the coating and have to be protected to avoid contamination during the process. The total weight of a mirror assembly is 250 kg and its height is 30 cm. The weather conditions in the desert are aggressive for the coated mirror surface due to pollution, humidity potentially causing corrosion, and sandstorms, and so the reflection will gradually reduce in time. ESO will install two magnetron coating machines in their Paranal Observatory, which is about 25 km from the ELT in 2021. They will be used for the initial coating of the mirrors and for the recoating of the mirrors after stripping. ESO intends to coat two segments every day and needs a reliable coater based on an industrial design. It is estimated that the recoating of the mirrors will be necessary with a two-year interval. The optical telescope will make observations in the visible, near and mid-infrared range, and therefore ESO prescribes a protected silver-based mirror coating. As can be seen from the figure, the reflectance of the silver-based mirror is clearly outperforming the reflectance of the aluminum mirror at wavelength range above 450 nanometer, while the aluminum coating performs better in the UV range. The coating stack selected by ESO is a 4 layers protected silver stack similar to the one developed for the Gemini telescope. Such type of coating is in use since 2004 and shows reasonable durability, although periodical stripping and recoating is still necessary. The buildup of the Gemini coating starts with a nickel chrome nitride layer to be deposited on the 50 mm thick zero-dur substrate. This substrate is supplied by Schott and is polished by Safran. Nickel chrome is a well-known adhesion promotion layer between glass and silver and also contributes in the protection of the silver against oxidation. Next, a 110 nanometer silver layer is sputtered onto the nickel chrome nitride base layer with an argon process gas. A minimal residual water content in the vacuum chamber during the silver sputtering is critical to attain optimal reflection of the silver layer. Hence, the coater is designed to reach a base pressure of 2×10⁻⁷ millibar, despite the outgassing of the large structure attached under the mirror. Process parameters for silver deposition should be well chosen to obtain a layer of low surface roughness, reducing the diffuse reflection. In order to protect the silver from environmental degradation, a few angstrom thick nickel chrome nitride is puttered on top of the silver to act as a barrier layer and nucleation layer for the 60 angstrom thick aluminum doped silicon nitride dielectric top layer. The formation of a dense and defect-free dielectric top layer that is well adherent to the silver reflecting layer is key to guarantee its low permeability to corrosive species that could penetrate through and react with the silver and result in a premature loss of the reflectance of the mirror. The Gemini 4-layer coating stack suffers from poor reflectivity in the UV range because the relatively poor reflectance of silver below 400 nanometer and due to the absorption of the protective coatings. By utilizing different dielectric protective top layers, it is possible to enhance the reflectance of silver without compromising infrared performance or coating durability. Therefore, while the initial M1 coating will be based on the Gemini stack, the coating plant is foreseen for future coating upgrades towards more complex stacks. The installation is also suitable for sputtering protected aluminum mirrors. AGC is proud to be selected as a supplier of the M1 coating plant. AGC Glass is a worldwide flat glass manufacturer, and our glass is used for architectural applications, for automotive glazing, and for displays. What people generally do not realize is that glass has become an increasingly high-tech material over the last decades. Indeed, today the glass sheets are frequently coated with thin layers on top of their surfaces to add additional functionalities to the material. The glass coaters that are manufactured and operated by AGC allow depositing complex stacks of metals, oxides and nitrides by magnetron sputtering. The typical glass sheet dimension to be coated with an architectural glass coater in Europe is 3.2 meter by 6 meter, and they allow the coating of millions of square meter of glass a year. The uniformity control of the several layers over the entire width of the glass sheet and the coating reproducibility are very important because the eye is very sensitive to the variations in the reflectance that will result. The coating uniformity within 1% can be attained on the 3.2 meter by 6 meter sheet dimension. It is such a design of inline glass coater that has been downsized for the M1 coating plant for ISO. This slide shows the schematic representation of the coater plant with, from left to right, a roller conveyor serving as a load and unload table. The load and unload table is equipped with a transport tray, where the operator will load and unload the mirror segment. This is also the location for the operator to fix the mirror segment on a clamping device and position the protective skirts on the sides of the hexagonal mirror segment to avoid the pollution of the backside during the sputtering process. As there are 133 different outer geometries for the 798 hexagonal mirror segments, it has been chosen for a manual adjustment of the skirts by the operator. Next, The mirror segment will be transferred to the load lock chamber, which is the only part that is not continuously under vacuum. It is separated from the atmosphere and the main process chamber by an isolation valve. The main process chamber is designed for DC and AC magnetron sputtering processes in sputter down arrangement in the reactive and or metallic mode. This chamber includes 6 compartments. All compartments are fully equipped, ready to receive a cathode. In principle, 3 cathodes would have been sufficient to make the Gemini stack. As such, the coater will allow to make more complex stacks during future upgrades. The overrun chamber is adjacent to the main process chamber. The total length of the coater is about 9.5 meters and the coater width is about 2.5 meters. The complete coating cycle goes like following. First, the clamping device with the mirror segment and its protective skirts is transferred from the load-unload table into the entry lock, and the 2 slit valves are closed. The pumping from atmospheric pressure till 10⁻⁴ millibar can start. Rough pumping starts with a screw pump and a roots pump for intermediate vacuum. The turbomolecular pumps will be used to further pump down. After approximately 20 minutes, the valve between load lock and process chamber opens and the mirror segment on its carrier is moved through the process chamber to the overrun area. Next, the valve between the process chamber and overrun chamber is closed. The overrun chamber and the process chamber are equipped with a cryogenic pump to allow reaching a base pressure of 2 10⁻⁷ millibar after the outgassing. The outgassing can certainly not be neglected during the dimensioning of the pumping unit, as the carrier and the mirror support with sensors and motor can contain a considerable amount of absorbed water. Because the coater should be able to coat 3 segments a day, the maximum cycle time between closure and venting is 3 hours, and the outgassing is accelerated by irradiating the substrate with UV lamps in the overrun area. After about 1.5 hours, the outgassing is finished and the base pressure of 2 10⁻⁷ millibar is reached. The freshly coated mirror can be taken to a tailor-made optical quality control station outside the coater to perform the specular and diffuse reflectance measurements at several positions on the mirror surface. A non-contact method is developed where the mirror is placed vertically in front of the spectrometer. The spectrometer can move on a beam with the same curvature as the mirror to keep perpendicularity during all measurements over the mirror surface. In addition, the mirror segment can rotate around its axis, making all points of the mirror surface accessible for measurement. A distance of 25 mm between the sensor and the mirror surface avoids any damage of the mirror segment during measurements. A Zeiss spectrometer with an integrating sphere is selected, measuring between 365 nanometer and 1650 nanometer. Each run will also include some small witness samples fixed on the carrier to be measured in the lab by Perkin-Elmer Lambda 1050S in the wavelength range between 300 nanometer and 3000 nanometer. The result obtained during the acceptance test in Germany is shown here and compared with the ISO minimum requirements, the red dots. It can be seen that the mirror outperforms the minimum requirements over the entire wavelength range with a reflection of 82% at 400 nanometer up till a reflection of 98% at 1000 nanometer. And this brings us to the list of accelerated aging tests that have been performed on the prepared mirror samples during the pre-acceptance test in Lauenfurde, Germany. And this brings me to the conclusions. AGC Plasma Technology Solutions designed the coating plant for the segments of the primary mirror of the extremely large telescope, based on its experience for the construction and operation of large area architectural glass coaters. The obtained coating results during the preliminary acceptance tests in Germany showed an outperformance of the reflectance with a Gemini-based protected silver layer stack in the visible and near infrared compared to the ISO minimum requirements. With this, I want to thank you for listening, and please do not hesitate to contact us with further questions.